To the Soviets, the most important aspect of a mine is the speed and ease of which it can be laid on the battlefield. There are four basic categories of Soviet mines: anti-tank, anti-personnel, anti-assault, and special mines. The Soviets have improved their mine warfare capabilities dramatically during recent years. Their conventional mines have always been a threat, but their advances in scatterable mine development has assured them as a continued threat on the modern battlefield. The Soviets classify mines three ways: the place of employment, land, sea, river, air; the destructive mission; and the method of detonation. Half of all Soviet standard mines have metallic bodies, while the rest are made of wood or plastic. The Soviets use a wide variety of improvised mines. Soviet doctrine emphasizes that any container can be filled with explosives, fitted with a fuse and a detonator, and serve as an effective landmine. The Soviets' use of mines on the modern battlefield will more often support offensive operations rather than defensive ones. Soviets consider minefields an excellent way to protect their flanks against enemy counterattacks. They continually develop different methods of remote mine laying, including artillery and air delivery. Soviet helicopters equipped with mine-laying chutes can quickly surface-lay an anti-tank minefield. Soviet threat forces have a variety of conventional mines in their inventory. The TMN-46 anti-tank mine serves mainly as a track breaker and has a pressure fuse for mechanical laying and a tilt rod fuse for hand laying. The TM-57 anti-tank mine is almost identical to the older TMN-46 with a few exceptions. It contains a larger charge and has improved fusing. It has a delay-armed pressure fuse used for mechanical laying and a tilt rod fuse for hand laying. There are four versions of the TM-62 series mine. The TM-62M is the Soviets' primary metallic anti-tank mine. The TM-62P has a plastic case. The TM-62D has a wooden case. The TM-62B is a caseless mine. Any of the TM-62 mines can be mechanically or hand-emplaced and have pressure, seismic, or tilt rod fusing. The TMK-2 full-width attack mine is a conical anti-tank mine with an adjustable tilt rod fuse. It can be hand-emplaced only. The LMG side-penetrating mine can be activated by tripwire or remote control. It can be employed to cover obstacles, routes, and wide-open areas. The PGMDM is a recently introduced scatterable anti-tank mine, which can be emplaced by aircraft and helicopters. It contains liquid explosive in a plastic casing and is pressure-fused. Although the full range of its capabilities is not yet known, it is an effective track breaker. The Soviets have an anti-tank scatterable mine about which little is known, except that it is emplaced by the BM-22 multiple rocket launcher. The PMR-2 is a mechanical mine-laying trailer, which consists of two chutes. It can be pulled by a variety of vehicles, but can only surface-lay pressure-fused mines. The PMR-3 is the standard mine-laying trailer, which has a single chute. It can surface-lay pressure-fused TM-46, TM-57, and TM-62 series anti-tank mines, or it can bury mines. The Soviet GMZ armored track mine layer works much like the PMR-3. It can surface-lay mines at about 10 kilometers per hour and bury mines at about 5 kilometers per hour. The Soviets have mine-laying chutes capable of being used with wheeled or tracked vehicles as well as with helicopters. These chutes are, however, restricted to surface-laying mines only. The Chinese Type 74 anti-tank mine-laying rocket system is remotely delivered. Each vehicle is equipped with 10 rockets and has an estimated range of 1,500 meters. It is believed that a four-vehicle battery can emplace a 400 by 400 meter minefield in one salvo.